Hi, everyone. First of all, thank you very much for the opportunity to give a presentation to you all. My name is Duveke and I'm a master research student from the Netherlands. And last year, I was lucky enough to do research and write a paper at the colorectal unit at the Royal Adelaide Hospital about intraoperative conditions that may predict prolonged postoperative ileus after colorectal surgery. The authors of the paper have nothing to declare. So PPOI after colorectal surgery has a negative impact on healthcare and patient outcomes. It is quite a common complication, and a wide variety of definitions is used in previous studies to define PPOI. We use the established definition of PPI derived from the publication by Father et al. This is the presence of two or more of the following symptoms after post-operative day four, being nausea or vomiting, the inability to tolerate oral diet over the last 24 hours, the absence of flatus over the last 24 hours, abdominal distension and radiologic confirmation, and this all with no prior resolution of PPOI. So pre-operative risk factors are quite well established, being age, male gender, smoking, and ASA classification. However, there's still much to learn about the effect of intraoperative variables on the development of PPOI. This is a single center prospective study, including 336 patients with over 60 pre- and intraoperative variables. Intraoperative variables were collected in theater during a one-off snapshot measure, and all patients undergoing colorectal resections with an age of 18 and above were included. We performed uni and multivariate logistic regression analysis to identify risk factors for PPOI. Then the results of the univariate analysis. Pre-operative variables that showed to have an effect on PPOI were male gender, an already known risk factor, the use of anticoagulants at time of surgery, and higher levels of pre-operative total protein. Then the results of the univariate analysis of intraoperative variables. Here we see that higher levels of fluids were administered in patients that developed PPOI than in patients that did not. Also, more site-to-site anastomoses were performed in the PPOI group. We investigated the effect of intraoperative opiate use in morphine equivalents per kilogram, but this did not show to have an effect on the development of PPOI. However, post-operative and intraoperative opioid use together did show a significant effect with a p-value of 0.02. And this variable also remained significant in the multivariate analysis, as well as the pre-operative risk factors, anticoagulation use, and higher levels of pre-operative total protein. We also saw that other complications were associated with PPOI, which were UTIs, pneumonias, and cardiac complications in particular. To conclude, this study suggests that intraoperative factors can contribute to the development of PPOI. The intraoperative risk factors found in the current studies are larger volumes of fluid depletion and site-to-site anastomosis, and in particular, opioid use. However, to determine the true impact of the found risk factors in the current study, further studies with larger sample sizes are required. Thank you all very much for your time.